Now that we have the tile JSON loaded, we need to parse it. So let's take a closer look at the structure of this file. There's a few things that should interest you about this file right away. First is the initial parameters discussing the size of the tiles that this map expects. The second is the number of vertical and horizontal tiles used. For instance, the width parameter here defines that this map is 100 tiles wide. Of course, the total size of the map in pixels is width times tile width, or 64 pixels per tile, giving you 6400 pixels. Secondly, you'll notice that there's a section devoted to what atlases this map uses, called tile sets. This section will list for each atlas the image location, given the absolute path from the editor, as well as the width and height of the input images, any particular names or properties that you've attached to the atlas, and most importantly, first GID, which we'll get into in a minute while we're parsing our layer data. Finally, we have a separate section of the JSON file devoted to the layers that you've defined. Now, each layer that exists has a data element, which actually lists out a large, very large, ludicrously large array of integer values that represent each tile that you've placed on this layer. Of course, this layer also has other properties like the height in number of tiles, as well as the opacity, and then any other information like the name and whether or not this tile is visible. This type parameter is also interesting because tiled allows you to have both tile layers and object layers. Of course, this layer you're looking at is defined as a tile layer.